Welcome to a video about arc length of a space curve. The goal is to determine the arc length of a space curve defined as a vector-valued function. If a smooth curve is defined by a vector-valued function, as we see here, on the closed interval from A to B, the arc length is given by this definite integral. And this definition of arc length should look pretty familiar to you, because when we talked about this using parametric equations, it was defined in almost the exact same way. However, we now can express the arc length formula as the definite integral from a to b of the magnitude of r prime of t with respect to t. Let's go and take a look at a couple of examples. And again, remember, this is the same as the definite integral from a to b of the magnitude of r prime of t dt. So let's go ahead and determine the derivative of this vector valued function and then determine its magnitude. The derivative of 2 cosine t is going to be negative 2 sine t. The derivative of 2 sine t is 2 cosine t. And the derivative of 2t would be 2. So the arc length is going to be equal to the definite integral on the interval from a to b, which in this case is from 0 to pi, of the square root of negative 2 sine t squared. That's going to be 4 sine squared t, plus 2 cosine t squared will be 4 cosine squared t, plus 2 squared, that's going to be 4. Now if we factor out 4 from these two terms, we're left with 4 times sine squared t plus cosine squared t, which we know is equal to 1, so this will give us 4 plus 4, or the square root of 8. So we can simplify this dramatically. This is equal to the definite integral from 0 to pi, the square root of 8, which is 2 square root 2 dt. So we'll have 2 square root 2 t, and we'll evaluate this at pi and 0. So when we sub in pi for t, we're going to have 2 square root 2 pi, and then minus 2 square root 2 times 0. So the arc length from 0 to pi of the space curve is going to be 2 square root 2 times pi. Let's go ahead and get a decimal approximation for that. This is about 8.9 units. Let's go and take a look at a graph of what we just found. Here we have our blue space curve, and I found the two vectors created by the vector valued functions at 0 and pi. So the arc length that we found is the distance from this point here to this point here. Let's go and take a look at one more example. Determine the arc length of the curve defined by the vector valued function, again on the interval from 0 to pi. Notice this vector valued function only has an x and a y component, which means the z component would be equal to 0. So we can still use the same formula. Let's go ahead and find the derivative of the given vector valued function, and then we'll apply our formula. So here we're going to have to apply the chain rule where u is equal to cosine. So this is really u to the third, so we'd have 3u squared, or 3 cosine squared t, times u prime. Well, the derivative of cosine t would be negative sine t, and then for the y component, u would be sine t, so we'd have 3 sine squared t times the derivative of u, or the derivative of sine, which is cosine t. Now before we set up this definite integral, notice the interval is from 0 to pi, but I provided the graph here because there is some symmetry that will allow us to modify how we set this up. Notice that when t is equal to 0, if we sub those values in here, the x component would be 1, the y component would be 0, so we'd be at this point here, and then at t equals pi over 2, we're going to be at 0, 1, or this point here. So we can actually integrate from 0 to pi over 2 and then double it because of the symmetry. And in fact, that's going to be necessary because if we integrate from 0 to pi, there's going to be a problem evaluating it at the end. So we're going to go ahead and set this up a little bit differently. We're going to integrate from 0 to pi over 2, then we're going to double it, then everything else will be the same. So we're going to have the square root of x of t squared, that's going to be 9 cosine to the 4th sine squared, plus, here we'll have 9 sine to the fourth cosine squared. Now let's go ahead and factor this and then simplify. Now these both have a common factor of 9, the square of 9 would be 3. Looking at the trig parts of these two terms, the greatest common factor would be cosine squared t, sine squared t. And then we're left with cosine squared from the first term plus sine squared t from the second term. Well, by now we know that cosine squared plus sine squared is equal to 1. So we're left with the square root of cosine squared t sine squared t, which is a perfect square. So let's go ahead and simplify this one more time. We're going to have 6 times definite integral from 0 to pi over 2 of just cosine t sine t. Let's go ahead and finish this on the next slide. This is going to require u substitution. Let's go ahead and let u equal sine t. So du is going to be equal to cosine t dt. So this would be u, and then all of this is going to be du. If we write this in terms of u, we're going to have 6 and then just u du. So this would be 6 times u squared over 2. Let's go ahead and rewrite this in terms of t. So 6 divided by 2, that's going to be 3, and then u is equal to sine t, so we'll have sine squared t. And you divide with this at 0 and pi over 2. So when t is pi over 2, sine t is going to be 1. 1 squared is still 1, so we'll have 3 minus, well, 3 times the sine of 0, which is 0. The result is 3 units. Going back to our graph, the distance from 0 to pi, meaning the distance from here to here and here to here, would be equal to 3 units. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you for watching.